Well, I had this trip planned for almost about a year and a half or so, and I really wanted to get the right crew to get to do this project. And this idea that I had was pretty much through the mounds, get this really nice mist and get some really cool drone shots as well. So I really wanted to get the right crew to get to there, and finally I got Maula, the iPhone photographer, and director Marcus Shaney. So these are the two that I ended up picking out to go to this trip, and we did. As soon as I kind of mentioned to them, they were pretty much on board with this project.
Sanjay called me up randomly one day and said, "Hey, let's go away for 4 days to Pigeon Forge, Tennessee, to shoot." I said, "Say no more."
We drove there. It took us about 12 hours with brakes.
We ended up renting a little car, the tiniest car that you can possibly think of, because we're on a budget, obviously, so.
The drive was awesome, especially when you notice the difference in the landscape from leaving from New Jersey, and you start climbing the elevation once you get to the mountains of Virginia and Maryland, and. And it was just it was gorgeous. It was an easy drive as
well. Actually, Mala pretty much took care of pretty much all this stay with us and behind the scenes of where we're gonna stay.
And we stayed in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. In an Airbnb.
We're staying at the Colonial Crest Condominiums.
Sleeping arrangements, it just so happens, Mal ended up booking just the king size bed. And two big guys, it was just like me and Marcus, and Mala, that wasn't gonna work. When we got in there, we were like, oh, it's only king size bed, bro. But then, he kind of figured it out because there was two other couches with the pull-out couches, which he kind of saved us money in that, which was kind of, smart of him. So me and Marcus ended up taking the couches, the two couches that were there.
It was beautiful. It was a one bedroom, but it was big for a one bedroom. And it was big enough for us. And it had a full kitchen, a full dining room, it had jacuzzi, the whole nine yards. It was awesome. And it was very clean.
So we drove to Smoky Mountain the first day just to go check it out. And we ended up seeing that it was a busy area. There was a lot of cars there. So we figured out really fast that if we didn't go and check out the place beforehand, we wouldn't know what we were expecting.
I was expecting it to be small, a small little town, like a one horse town with like a sheriff and stuff like that. But when we got there, it was anything but. It was humongous.
Food-wise, we originally planned to cook at home. But us boys, that's not gonna work out. So we ended up just kind of eating out and cooking at home, half, both a little bit of half and half.
Little that we knew, Mala actually wanted to be in culinary school, so.
We made, what was it, chicken one time. We made fish, salmon one time.
So we got some roasted peppers and we got a salmon.
Salmon.
That salmon was absolutely flawless.
When we got there, we drove around for a bit just to see, just to experience it. It'll give us a little pre-trip.
First day we got there, we basically kind of ventured around. We saw that the city was a really busy city.
Gear. Wanted to take everything possible that I have, so I did take a lot of gear just so I can have everything that we wanted.
All right, guys, so right now we're recording this with the new Canon 1DX Mark II. Obviously, it does the video with 120 frames, guys. It's freaking amazing. I know you guys seen my Smoky Mountains video already, so that's pretty much what this camera, all that video that was shot in there, was through this camera itself.
Me, personally, what I did was I took some time-lapse of when I was there, and I also took some photos of the dome and the mountains when I was there.
So when Sanjay initially called me, he wanted me to be in charge of his aerial footage down in the Smokies. And so when we got down there, that's what I was doing. My task was to get most of the aerial footage. As far as aerial was the DJI Mavic Pro Platinum.
Yes, I love doing my iPhone photography. I enjoy that. I started off with an iPhone 6S. Now I'm using an iPhone 11 Pro to do that.
We had to drive up 5,000 feet to get to Klingman's Dome, which when I wasn't expecting that to be as beautiful as it was either.
That was our original location spot that we wanted to go to. And that was on top of the great Smoky Mountain.
You take a brief hike up a steep mountain to get to Klingman's Dome.
Klingman's Dome, where the sun was rising and the clouds were being pushed away. So you could see almost a 32, 34 minute time lapse where you see the sun pushing the clouds and it's coming at you. It's really cool.
All right, guys, so I'm here at the Klingman's Dome, and it was brutal coming up here, especially with the gear bag and all.
This is not good, man. Well, first of all, I'd like to say, this is no joke. The path from the base to Klingman's Dome, I think we're only halfway through, and we've took two breaks already. We've taken two breaks. But Klingman's Dome, yeah, it's going to be worth it.
Up here from down there, which is ridiculous, guys. I mean, it's a hike from up there to here, but you know what? I think the shots were definitely worth it. Let me know in the comments down below if those shots were epic and if it was really worth it. But now we're actually heading down. Going down is much easier than going back up itself. And we ended up going to Bald River Falls, and amazing. I mean, absolutely amazing. Right now we're at Bald River Falls and we're about to get this shot. Guys, this falls is amazing. We just drove by it. I can't wait to show you guys. The shots that I wanted, you kind of had to climb down over the bridge, and a lot of people weren't doing that because they were scared. You know me, I gotta do what I gotta do to get that one shot. So yes, me and Mala ended up going down. Yeah, I fell into the water several, you know, like twice, but my feet were all wet, my sneakers were all wet. I didn't care. I needed to get that shot. So we ended up getting that shot. And I'll show you that now.
It's about a 2-hour drive from Pigeon Forge, but it's worth the trip. We went there and we got some footage immediately. I was, Sanjay said, you know, fly the drone here, get that. While he went in the trenches with Mo, he went down at the base of the falls to get that those perfect shots that you're gonna see in the video. And everything, he even fell in. He fell in the water twice just to get the shot. And it was, you know, it's hilarious. I wish I would've got that, but. A bakery named Teleco Greens Bakery, and when we got there, the smell alone, just like you float in, you know, like Pepe Le Pew used to just like float to the smell of the perfume and all that.
The workers were amazing, and this one girl in there, I think, I forgot her name, was Blue or something, I'm not really sure, but she was amazing. She actually told us what to get, what to do, and we ended up, I think I got a brownie cheesecake. Oh my freaking God. I must have gained 20 pounds just by eating that one little brownie cheesecake.
seller, maybe like the carrot cake muffin or the cinnamon roll. That would be my favorite.
Cinnamon roll?
I think that's what, yeah.
Wow, Chocolate Chip Cookie.
And how is that?
Amazing.
Marcus?
A cheesecake. Excellent.
I myself, guys, I did get a cheesecake brownie. Oh my God, it is absolutely delicious.
Fun is what this whole trip was all about, and you know, for us to do some really dope shots and some really cool footages and obviously have fun as well. So yeah, it wasn't just all work. We made sure that we had fun too.
What's up, guys? We're at Dave & Buster's in Smoky Mountains. And Marcus actually challenged me to the basketball. It's called the Hot Shots.
Of course, Marcus talking a lot of crap on basketball. And of course, you know me, I talked a lot of crap on basketball as well. So there was a showdown that went in Dave & Buster's. We did end up doing some basketball shootout.
Attempt from Mr. Marcus Shaney. Let's go.
It was Marcus's day. He ended up beating me. I think the score, I'm not really sure, but it was high. He actually won that one. So yes, I had to listen to a lot of trash talking after that, but he deserved it. He won, and that's what it comes down to. Turned out to be competition night, pretty much. So then we started going, driving around. We saw go-karts.
Who won the go-kart? That was Sanjay. Sanjay won the go-kart. See, Marcus won the basketball because, you know, that's in his gene. But Sanjay, he's like, I'm from India. I know how to drive.
Yeah, I redeemed myself. I redeemed myself.
During the racing time, right, he went around me twice. So that means he did two more laps than I did. But then again, I wasn't really trying. You know, that was the main reason. I was just relaxing, just testing out.
So I had a tremendous time. Me and the fellas, we were working, but it wasn't work. We were having fun the whole trip.
If you have the opportunity to go to Tennessee, I would definitely suggest you go.
Yeah, the whole trip pretty much went really nice. We went just about a couple of days, 4 days or so. We drove down and it was awesome. I think we had an amazing time. I did get a lot of footage. If you guys haven't seen the cinematic video yet, make sure you watch that before you watch this. So,
all right, guys, so this is a wrap for the Smoky Mountain trip. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this vlog so far. But if you haven't seen our cinematic video yet, click on the link right here somewhere. Just to let you guys know, this trip and that cinematic video would not be possible without these two guys right here, Mo and Director Shaney. So if you guys like these kinds of videos, please click on the like button, comment down below, and share the video.
Definitely.
Peace.